In this tutorial, we'll explore three fantastic methods to extend your images and backgrounds in Photoshop like a pro. Method one, using Content Aware Fill. One of the methods that has been in Photoshop for some time now is Content Aware Fill. This tool analyzes the surrounding pixels and reconstructs new areas based on what it sees, blending seamlessly with the existing scene. I've extended the canvas on this image just to show you how this works. Now I'm going to come up here to the toolbar and go to the rectangular marquee tool and select the area that I want to expand. Now I'm going to go up to the edit menu and select content aware fill. A new window will now appear showing you a preview of the edited image. You can fine tune the fill according to your preferences by adjusting the sampling area. So the green color is the area that's being sampled, and I can paint away just a little bit and that changes what is sampled in the image. Once you're satisfied, click on OK. And here is the image that's extended using Content Aware Fill. For more on how to use Content Aware Fill, check the card above or find the link in the description. Method two, using Generative Expand. This tool analyzes your entire image and intelligently extends the canvas based on its understanding of the scene's textures, patterns, and lighting. Step one, select the crop tool from the left sidebar. Alternatively, you can press C on your keyboard and this should open up the crop window. Now at the top in the menu bar for my crop tool, it says fill. Make sure it says Generative Expand. You have other options here, but you want to select Generative Expand. Now I'm going to select the frame on the left-hand side here, and I'm going to expand the canvas. Down here, you have your contextual taskbar. If you wish to let AI expand your image, leave the prompt empty and hit Generate. Based on your image, Photoshop will generate and expand the background. It will give you three options, which you can select from the contextual taskbar or properties panel. Here's my three options. Select which one I want. I want that one, so I'm going to delete this one. And if you're unhappy with the results, you can click on Generate option again to ask Photoshop to create new results. And here's the before, and there's the after. Method three, use Photoshop's Generative Fill to expand images. Essentially, both Generative Expand and Generative Fill use the same technology to expand your images. However, the way they differ is that Generative Expand works best when used on a background image. As for Generative Fill, it comes handy if you're working with multiple layers or have a predefined canvas on which you fill the area using AI. Step one, I'm going to use the Rectangular Marquee tool and select the empty area and have a little bit of the selection go into the image. Then in my contextual taskbar, I can either enter a prompt to describe my preferred expansion, or I can leave it blank and let AI decide based on my image. So I'm gonna leave it blank. I'm gonna click in my Generative Fill. I'm gonna leave it blank and I'm gonna click Generate. Generative Fill, like Generative Expand, has created three different variations. So if I click on them, I can see which one I like. I kind of like this one that has a sink over there. Looks like a sink, more counter space. I can get rid of the variations that I don't want. Or if I'm not satisfied, I can add text into the prompt, or I can just click Generate again. For more information on how to use Generative Fill, click on the link in the description. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something new. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tutorials on Photoshop. Remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.